If you clicked on this video, then you're probably trying to decide whether you should get the Siren X or pay half the price and get the Siren Mini. So let's talk about it. But I should warn you that the answer is probably neither of them. Let's talk about it.
Alright, so we have the Razer Siren Mini as well as the X. With the Mini, you're gonna get the microphone, of course, as well as the base and support rod. You get a cable with a ribbed texture that's USB-A to micro USB. And of course, you're gonna get some paperwork and some stickers. Now with the Siren X, you're gonna get a heavier base and support rod, a thick braided cable that also uses USB-A to micro USB, and of course, paperwork and stickers. Now regarding the build of the microphone for the Mini, it's mostly made of plastic with a metal mesh. There's no buttons and knobs, but there's a slot for you to plug in the micro USB to power the microphone, as well as a threaded mount for the stand. As for the build of the X, it's still mostly plastic, but there is a bit more metal used. There is a volume knob, but it's for headphone monitoring, not gain, and there is a mute button, which is always nice to have. Towards the back, we have a very nice clean look with the Razer logo. On the bottom, you'll find inputs for power and headphone monitoring, and a mounting hole for stands. Assembly for both is pretty straightforward. You just basically screw on everything together, and you're essentially good to go. When on the table, the mics are essentially very similar in size, and both feature the same swiveling mount so you can adjust the microphone to a better position for capturing your voice. Major differences are also pretty clear, as the X has the headphone volume knob as well as a mute button which turns red when muted. Now something I don't like in the X so much is the angled cable in the front of the microphone that only angles to the left. This wouldn't have been a problem if they used USB-C, since USB-C is reversible, but since they chose micro USB, we're stuck with this. The Mini thus wins in this department because they smartly put the cable in the back, and it goes flush with the microphone, so that's very nice aesthetically. Now I did mention that the stands do weigh different, with the Mini being lighter at 122 grams and the X being at 219 grams. But regardless, both feel quite stable on the table, so there's no problem here. So that finally then brings us to the sound test.
All right, currently we are recording off the little Siren Mini right here at a pretty standard distance away from me on my table, where I would put it for like communications, Discord, and whatnot. And I have the volume set to like 100 on my Windows computer. So if you want to change the settings, there is no gain knob on either of these actually. So if you want to change the settings for how loud it will get and how much it'll pick up, it'll depend on the settings you have on your computer. So, you know, you have to go through your Windows settings, set it from there, not on the thing. There's just no knob. That's just how things go. That being said, let's get started more on a little comprehensive test. Let's test out its abilities as a super cardioid microphone. So it should cancel my voice from the sides and around a little better. So from the front, here's how it's going to sound. It's going to capture me clearest here. But now if I slowly move it to the side, it'll capture my voice a bit less and I'll be a little less there. Now if I move it around and I go to the back side, it should capture my voice very quietly at all. If, you know, very much at all, move it around to the side once again. And then slowly go back to the front. Let's put that guy down over her. Alright, let's try typing now. So if I were to like click and type and whatnot. So let's see if it catches my clicking at 100% volume here. Alright, let's test typing as I talk over and when I don't at all. So here's me typing. Alright, and that's the Siren Mini. Alright, now let's test the sound of the Razer Siren X. And something I should note before I get started is that it does have a larger diaphragm capsule inside. So it's going to be more sensitive to sound in general. It's going to capture them acoustic sources of energy a little bit better. So that being said, let's test out the super cardioid polar pattern. So we're going to talk from the front, where it'll capture my voice quite well, and we'll roll it around to the side, where it'll capture my voice less, down to the back, where it should capture it at least, and now all the way back to the side, and once again we're going to the front. Let's get that blood down here. Use my mouse, I'm gonna click around to see if it captures my voice while I'm like clicking and typing at the same, well, clicking and talking at the same time. And when I don't talk. Now let's type and talk at the same time to see if it captures the sound of my voice while I'm also like typing, and see if it gets my keys when I'm talking. And how about when I'm not talking? Alright, and that's how it's going to sound. Alright, now those of you who are very keen ears may have noticed that when I held this microphone closer to my face, it just sounded a lot better, capturing more of my bassy tones, and this is due to what's known as the proximity effect. With the proximity effect, with the microphone being closer, it's able to capture your like your acoustic sound energy to the capsule in here better, and also give you a better representation of sound, as well as increasing the bass notes that it should be capturing from your voice. So then my voice sounds very bassy if I'm talking into it right now, versus if I put it on the table and it's further from my face, and I'm actually probably talking over the microphone if I'm playing games like most of you guys would be with this microphone. Like when it's talking over it, you're not gonna sound as good as when it's actually facing it or when the microphone's actually close to your face. You know, that's just how it goes. And this doesn't just apply to this microphone, it applies to basically every other microphone like the Mini, which we're gonna show in just a second. Let me just switch. And now here's how the Siren Mini is gonna sound with like the proximity effect, so it can capture those deeper tones of my voice a little bit better. And another thing about the Mini is it uses a smaller sound capsule, so I can have the microphone closer to my face simply because the capsule's smaller and is less sensitive to sound. With the Siren X, I had to be a little bit quieter at the same distance because it would start clipping at 100% volume because it's the diaphragm of the capsule was larger, so it's able to capture more of that acoustic energy. Versus this guy, it's a little smaller, so I can worry less about accidentally clipping if my volume is set at 100. If I don't want to clip on the X, I just have to turn down the volume a bit. But you know, that aside, back on like the whole proximity effect and why I'm showing this right now, and why it sounds different on the table, is because a lot of you guys who are buying this microphone are going to be putting it on the table, and this is a more realistic expectation that you guys would have if you're just buying these microphones to put on your table and chat and play games with. A lot of reviewers out there, you may have noticed, have put them on boom arms or put them really close to their mouths for like a sound test, so it sounds real good. And you might have bought these mics or another microphone that you thought sounded good from reviews, and when you're actually using it on your table, it doesn't sound quite as good. And the reason might just be because your microphone isn't close enough to you. To do so, you'll need something like a taller mic stand, or maybe you buy a boom arm like I do. And that's just another cost on top of things. And for me, I wanted to give you guys a realistic explanation or a realistic expectation of how the microphone's gonna sound if you just have it on your table, like at waist level. Maybe you have a higher table, so the microphone's taller and, you know, closer to your face, and it's gonna sound a little better. Maybe it's not. But, you know, anyway, now you know why it sounds the way it does and why your microphone might sound the way it does when it's on your table. So, you know, that's just how microphones are, and now you know. I might make a separate video on this, so we'll see. All right, with all the explanations said and done and how microphones function, let's get back to the main topic of which one you should get, the X or the Mini. And in my personal opinion, I do think that the Mini is just a better value proposition. It costs half as much as the X and doesn't lose all that much. The X, I do think, has like a better ability of capturing the bass range of my voice, so I think for sound-wise, it does sound a bit better. And other than that, the other options aren't that much more worth it because, you know, a mute button's convenient and all, but you can just mute yourself on the software. And the volume knob is, it's nice and all, but it's only nice if you actually use like the microphone port on bottom. If you're plugging into like a sound card or like plugging into your computer for listening for your headphones, then it's, you know, not really that worth it, to be honest. So, you know, between these two, I think the Mini is just a lot better. But what if I told you that there is an option out there that's better built, instead of being plastic, actually being made of metal and having more features, including gain control, but only being $10 more expensive than the Mini, being just $60. Behold the Fifine K678, essentially very similar to the Mini in terms of its shape, but at the size and features of the Siren X, but it also has a gain knob in the back for more control to make it a lot more useful. Now, I actually did review this microphone already, so I'll leave a little link in the corner in case you want to know more about it. Now, while you are getting a lot of money for the features that you are getting on this microphone, there is one downside to it that might be major to some people, and it's the fact that this microphone is a cardioid microphone and not super cardioid. So while it will capture like sounds in front of it more and be more focused on that and canceling sounds around it better, it doesn't do as well as a job as either the Sirens that have like the super cardioid polar pattern.
Cardioid microphones just capture more like of the background noise when it's happening compared to like say a supercardioid microphone, which will capture the sound still if it's very loud and close to it, but will capture them less as loud. So, you know, there's that to take into consideration.
At the end of the day, the choice is still yours depending on what your needs are and what your environment is like. So do think about what your area and the place you're gonna be using this mic is gonna be like, and then make your decision from there. Now, if you're looking to purchase any of these microphones, I will have links in the description for you guys to buy from, and they are affiliate links. So if you buy from those links, I will get a slight kickback, which will help run this channel. With that being said, if this video helped you out, do leave me a like, because that will help me out in this whole YouTube algorithm thing. If you love the content, do remember to subscribe for more, and do hit that notification bell so you know when I'm posting next. Also, I'm now on Twitch these days. Schedule's a bit hectic and random, but we'll figure it out eventually. So hop in down there, link in the description in case you want to watch me play games and chat with me while I'm playing those games. Oh, that being said, this is pretty long of a video, so let's end it right now. Do have a nice day, and I'll see you guys next time.